I first started riding mountain bikes and wanted to learn fakies, I soon realized they're not easy. Going backwards makes the bike behave nothing like a bike usually does. And of course it's different. The steering gets reversed, you have to pedal backwards to keep the hub from engaging, and the wheel that does the steering is now on the back of the motion. But why isn't learning this skill similar to when you learn normal riding, which just clicks and then you're able to ride for as long as you want? Instead, it takes hours until you can do a couple meters, and much longer until you can control it well. So, what's the secret behind this? Let's look at how you balance when you ride normally. When you steer, it makes the front wheel roll to that side, and the rear wheel follows in the same direction. An interesting fact is, before you turn the bars to where you want to go, you always have to turn them the opposite way first. Because if you steer to where you want to go directly from going straight, you just fall over to the other side. But by briefly steering the opposite way, you start to lean to where you want to go, and then you can steer into the turn. But how do you stay straight? It comes down to steering the bike's contact patch with the ground back underneath your center of gravity whenever you fall to one side, which means you have to steer in the direction you're falling. If you get into the actual physics behind this, it turns out understanding why you can ride a bike is actually more complicated than doing it. But with what I just explained, we can now ask, how does the way you get the bike's contact patch with the ground back under your center of gravity change when you ride backwards? The steering is reversed now. So you simply turn the bars the opposite way of where you're falling to and that's it, right? No, that's where it gets odd. Let's say you steer to the right. That'll make the front wheel go left, but the rear wheel to the right. This has the effect that, depending on if you have your weight over the front or the back of the bike, the way you have to steer is completely different. Therefore, your position over the bike is crucial to mastering this trick. When you first try it, your instinct is to lean forward, because the steering feels more natural that way. You just make the front wheel roll in the direction you fall. The catch is, that doesn't work once you're going faster, because the effect on where the rear wheel goes gets too great. You can see here how much the bike turns just from keeping the front under me. At higher speeds, that would make you fall over. So if you want to go fast, you have to move your weight back and instead steer the rear wheel to where you fall, which on the other hand doesn't work below a certain speed because the rear will not move over quickly enough. And that's what makes riding backwards difficult. You have two different ways of steering and have to apply the right one depending on your speed and where your weight is over the bike. It took me a couple of months to figure this out back when I was learning them, but if you start out already knowing about it, you should have an easier time. And to give you even more of an advantage, here are my tips on how and what to practice. To get started, a quarter pipe is probably the best place to learn them on. If you don't have a ramp, you can also lock your front brake to do a small stoppy, keep it locked and let yourself fall back. Or if you don't have a front brake either, you can use an obstacle and push your front wheel against it to do the same thing. You could also use a hill, and obviously 180 hops or pivots as more advanced ways to get into a fakie. The first thing you can try is to just see what it feels like for you to roll backwards at a low speed. Maybe you'll already manage to balance a bit naturally. I suggest learning slow fakies first, because you'll be able to cover some distance safely and get comfortable with moving backwards. A simple way you can hack your progression at this point is to push yourself backwards with your feet on the ground while leaning onto the bars and then steering the front wheel left and right to learn how much you have to steer. The speed at which you pedal can also influence your balance, and pedaling slightly ahead of your hub's engagement is usually the best. So you're not going wild with the pedaling, and you also don't apply pedal pressure which would mess with your balance and slow you down. But you can use pedal pressure when you want to go from fakieing back to riding forwards, to stop or turn around with your front wheel off the ground, which you can later progress to other techniques. But this video is about how to hold a fakie, not how to get out of it, so I'm not going into more detail. Once you've practiced enough and you're comfortable rolling backwards, you can now try going faster and leaning back. This definitely works best using a ramp, because you can simply roll up a bit further to add more speed gradually. For some people it helps to do a little hop at the transition between forwards and backwards, but you should be able to do it without that as well. And if you have a ramp, but it's too small to get enough speed, you can make it an imaginary bigger ramp. But usually any quarter pipe should give you enough speed if you roll up far enough. The body position to aim for now is very central over the bike and feels slightly leaned back. You can see here that I don't have my center of gravity all the way over the rear wheel, but a tad behind the bottom bracket. Try to keep your upper body centered and do all the balancing through steering. You'll notice that steering the rear wheel to where you fall will get more and more effective the faster you go, and the fakie will gain in stability. There is a great exercise hack for this again, which is to roll down the ramp as straight as you can and alternate quickly between steering left and right. Some of those random steering inputs will actually balance you, and by doing this a couple times, you feed your brain with data on what certain steering inputs do. You can also try sitting down on your bike, feet on the ground, and pushing yourself backwards. The first method works wonders sometimes. And finally, a small trick that always helps me balance in a fakie is to look at the stem. That concludes the advice I can give you in a few minutes of video. The rest is up to you putting in the hours. But I hope some of the tips help you. On the last video, many of you have been asking for more tutorials, especially one on bunny hops. And the good news is, I've already got that tutorial in the making. It's just taking much more work than expected. So keep an eye out for the bunny hop video in the future. I want to thank my patrons, Todd Grassman, Daniel Wenger, Michael McKennedy, and Ray Houston. And thanks a lot for watching, everyone. I'll see you next time. Bye.